Dr.Dilip's MMS, and from this week on, we are planning to introduce a like new type of interaction in this online platform called Dr.Dilip's MMS Weekly, where I'll be discussing like 1 to 2 questions per week with a short video description. So that I hope this might be helpful for your exam. So this was yesterday's question where I've mentioned as a 55-year-old man with cirrhosis number 1 was admitted in the ICU with seizures and confusion. The EEG is shown below. So what are these EEG complexes? So I've given 4 options: PLETS, periodic lateralized epileptiform discharges, FIRDA, that is frontal intermittent rhythmic delta activity, C is triphase equation, D is spike and slow wave complexes. So what are these? First of all, so since it's a short description, I'm going to tell 3 basic things with regards to the CCG which you have to note. So number one, first thing you have to discuss is where you see the discharges. For example, you have to know which is right and which is left in the EEG nomenclature. So usually the right-sided leads are actually given by even numbers and the left-sided leads are generally denoted by the odd numbers. And you can see this is F3 here. So F3 means it is, it's an odd number, so it's likely to be on the left. So here you can see this is 0 to 0 to is an even number, so which means it belongs to the right side. It's an even number, so it belongs to the right side. So apart from that, you have to know this F stands for frontal, and O stands for occipital region, and C stands for central regions and all these things. So first of all, the basic thing is you have to know whether it is right or the left. So number two, second thing in the EEG, what you have to note is whether whatever you see, whatever discharges you're going to see, whether you're going to tell whether it's generalized discharge or whether it is a lateralized discharge. So in general, whenever you think about a generalized discharge, so you can tell it's going to present in both the hemispheres and almost in all the leads. So whenever you think about a lateralized discharge, it's going to be a little bit focal, or we can even call it as hemispherical. So either it is restricted to a single hemisphere or either it is restricted to a particular area in a particular hemisphere. So the next thing you need to know whenever you discuss about in these kind of ECG, these kind of EEGs, is the third thing. So third thing, whether it is periodic or whether it is intermittent. So what do you mean by periodic or intermittent? So periodic in the sense, it usually refers to a single discharge. And it has a inter-discharge interval. So it comes and you have a typical inter-discharge interval between the discharges. So that's what we call it as periodic. So whenever you talk about intermittent, so in intermittent, you generally do not have this typical intermittent, inter-discharge interval. So it can come in bursts or it can come in a single discharge. So that is different and that needs a lot of other explanations as well. But intermittent will not have any inter-discharge interval. So now characteristic inter-discharge interval. In other words, you can tell this periodic discharges are generally tends to be regular. So, and they have a typical characteristic inter-discharge interval, whereas, intermittent discharges do not have a regular inter-discharge interval. So they are sometimes suddenly it comes in between. So that's what we call intermittent. So on the top of this, when you want to discuss this particular EEG, so what you can see in this particular EEG is one interesting thing, that first of all, you are going to see this kind of complexes which you're going to see, and you're going to see bilaterally. For example, you are seeing an odd numbered leads also, that is, which is going to be on the left side. And you can even see in the, for example, let me take this in the even number leads also. You're going to see in the even number leads also. You're going to see in the odd number leads, and you're going to see in the even number leads also, which means it is bi-hemispherical. So it is not lateralized or it is not focal. It is going to be more of generalized waveform. So next thing, is it periodic? Yes, absolutely. It is periodic. So how can you tell it's a periodic? Because you can see clearly there is a typical, inter-discharge interval and almost near regular. It is almost near regular. You can see a typical inter-discharge interval as well. So for instance, when I want to discuss this EEG, so I can tell this is number one, a generalized discharge. And second, what you can see is it's a periodic discharge as well, since it has a very regular discharge interval. So this is generalized and periodic epileptiform spikes. epileptiform spikes. And one peculiar type of a generalized, in a generalized epileptiform spikes itself has a lot of other, you know, like classifications, but one important type of a generalized epileptiform spike, as you know, we call it as triphasic waves. So what are these triphasic waves? So triphasic waves, you can, this is a characteristic example of a triphasic EEG, triphasic waves in the EEG. So what you can clearly see is you can see a typical, you know, like one negative deflection. Remember, in EEG, upward deflections are generally called negative and downward deflections are generally called positive. And second, you can see one, you know, like another positive deflection, which is a downward deflection. And once again, you can see another negative deflection, which is in the upward direction. So you can see an initial negative, then a positive, and then again a negative deflection. So this, there are three deflections, characteristic deflections. So that's why we call this a triphasic waves. So the next question, it's a generalized periodic epileptiform spikes. So what are the important examples of a generalized periodic epileptiform spikes on triphasic waves? So where do you see this triphasic waves? So that's the next question. So where are you going to see this triphasic waves? So number one, you know, like as far as the, I mean, triphasic waves can be generally seen in any metabolic encephalopathy, It can be seen in any metabolic encephalopathy. But in general, in exam, what you have to know is it's seen, it's a characteristic feature of a hepatic encephalopathy as far as exams are concerned. So this is a very, very important question in exam. So, but on the other hand, it can be seen in uremic encephalopathy. It can be seen in hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy as well. It can be seen in hyperglycemic hyperosmolar syndrome, so which is called as HSS, and which happens in usually in type 2 diabetic patients, or it can be seen in hypoglycemic patients as well. So which means this, you know, like triphasic waves are generally non-specific, and you cannot tell in reality that whenever there is a triphasic wave, it should be a hepatic encephalopathy. It could be any form of metabolic encephalopathy, but in exam, the general idea is to, you know, like know about hepatic encephalopathy and triphasic wave association. So what about the other options? So I have given some other options also. For example, I have given about plets, I have given about ferida. So what are these? So what are these plets and what are these ferida? So based on the nomenclature, so next thing, let us see about the plets. So plets are nothing but periodic lateralized epileptiform discharges. So clearly, you know that whenever you tell it's periodic, so since it's periodic, it's going to be regular and it's going to be having a typical inter-discharge interval. So this is what you mean by a periodic, number one. So whenever you call lateralized means it's going to be on the particular hemisphere or in a particular region. So it's going to be hemispherical or it localized to a particular region. So that's what we call lateralized, and obviously epileptiform discharges. So which we'll discuss on a separate video, what are epileptiform spikes and what are slow waves and spikes. So now let me show you about the example of a pled and how it looks like. So this is how a pled is going to look like, for example. So what you're essentially seeing in this EEG is nothing but these are some of the epileptiform spikes you are seeing here, and you can clearly see it is lateralized, number one. So you are not going to see in this odd numbered leads, you are going to see only in this even numbered leads. So you can see only in the even numbered leads, and you are not going at least predominantly in the odd leads. You are going to see only the even numbered leads, which are nothing but this is lateralized to the right hemisphere. These epileptiform discharges are, number one, it's lateralized to the right hemisphere. So clearly, you know, first of all, it is lateralized first, and second, what you are going to see is a very clear, you know, like inter-discharge interval. It is nearly regular, but still you are going to see a very clear and almost near regular inter-discharge interval. So second thing, it is periodic. So since these are epileptiform discharges, so it can be called as periodic lateralized epileptiform discharges. So whenever you have plets, so what can cause plets? So that's the next question. So generally, plets can be caused by anything. So usually the EEG, what I have discussed here, we call it as uniplets, or rather it's called as unilateral plets. Similarly, you can have a bilateral plets also, we call it as bilateral independent plets. So that needs a separate, you know, like video discussion for. So this is a typical example of a PLED or a unilateral PLED. So the most common cause of a unilateral PLED is going to be an ischemic stroke and nothing else. So it's going to be an ischemic stroke, or it can be seen in any tumors. Very commonly, we generally see these PLEDs in glioblastoma multiform, or this can be seen in any space occupying lesions on one side of the brain, or it can be seen in, like, for example, an abscess, which is also a space occupying lesion, or you can see in any type of conditions that causes cerebral edema on one particular site. So there are a lot of reasons why you get PLEDs. And the third thing in this question, what we have been thinking about, is FRIDA. So this is the last thing I'm going to discuss on it. So that is FRIDA. So that is called as focal intermittent rhythmic delta activity. Frontal intermittent rhythmic delta activity. So how does FRIDA will look like? So what do you mean by FRIDA? So typically, you know, like this is a clear example of a FRIDA. Number one, this is a FRIDA EEG. This is a frontal intermittent. So number one, so this is seen in both the hemispheres, which you can prove it here. So first, if you zoom this EEG and see, you can clearly see this is in the odd number. You can see clearly something over here. So this is odd numbered leads, so which clearly tells it is present on the left side. So next, you can see this kind of discharges in the even numbered leads also. So clearly you can see in the even numbered leads, which means this is, you know, like not, you know, like it's focal or lateralized. It's something called, it's a generalized thing, number one. So second thing, you can see these spikes and they don't have any regular intermittent, you know, like if you see, take this waveforms and you can see this waveforms. These are clearly delta waveforms, which I have to, you know, like prove by the timing only. Otherwise, I cannot prove right now. But trust me, this is a delta waveform. And you can see this one delta after the other. It comes, you know, like sequentially one after the other. There is no, you know, like inter-discharge interval. There is absolutely no inter-discharge interval. And this actually comes in the form of bursts. There are bursts are nothing but a group of waves clustered together is what we call it as a burst. So this is not, you know, like a periodic waveform. This is first of all, this is generalized, number one. So what you can clearly see is a generalized waveform. This is definitely not lateralized. And second thing, what you can see is this is definitely not periodic. So which means what I'm trying to tell is this is intermittent. So it's intermittent and generalized. And one more interesting thing, what you can see in this EEG is that you can notice these are predominant in the frontal lobes. These are very, very predominant in the frontal. So very, very predominant in the frontal. F stands for frontal. So in the temporal, you can see this blunts out. And you can see again in the frontal, you can see typically like all these waveforms, and in the frontal region, and again you can typically see all these waveforms, and in the parieto occipital region it again blunts out, and you can see in the frontal region and again in the frontotemporal region clearly you can see a cluster of waves, whereas in the, you know, like temporal occipital region it clearly blunts out. So it's not that prominent or that significant. So clearly what I can infer from this is predominantly in the frontal region. And it's intermittent, definitely not periodic. And it has a very rhythmic delta activity. So that's what we call it as FRIDA. So where do you see FRIDA? So similar to how you see a triphasic wave, you know, like which is a generalized periodic epileptiform discharge, FRIDA can also be seen in any condition that causes metabolic encephalopathy. So any condition that produces metabolic encephalopathy, you can have FRIDA. But apart from that, as far as exams are concerned, so whenever you think about FRIDA, think about a raised ICP, you know, like raised intracranial pressure due to any cause. So you cannot tell what is the exact cause, but due to any cause, if it's a raised intracranial pressure, you can get this FRIDA, that is frontal intermittent rhythmic delta activity. So I've discussed three EEGs and I've discussed certain nomenclatures. So hopefully you got it right and you understood and like a significant bit of this tough topic. And let me see you with the next video description in the next Dr. Dilip MMS Weekly, and thank you very much.